Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Michael Okello, hepatobiliary surgeon and the president of the Society of Uganda Gastrointestinal and Endoscopic Surgeons. You're all welcome to the Dr. Rita Mozart Transplant Center, which was set up following the transplant law guidelines. We have our main theater adjacent to the ICU, and this theater was commissioned by the Director General of Health Services in August last year. And we are awaiting the formation of the Transplant Council so that we get accredited. For the meantime, we are doing all the complex surgeries here, advanced laparoscopic surgeries, liver resections, Whipple's resections. And following a paper we published just this year in February, we started doing these complex liver surgeries in 2018 after our training in India. And from that time, our outcomes are improving. And patients who that needed to travel out of the country can now be helped within the country because of the expertise that they have now. And as we await for approval, we look forward to starting transplant surgeries.
My name is Dr. Chiemba Henry. I am a general surgeon at Lubaga Hospital. Briefly about the Dr. Rita Musa Transplant Center, named after Dr. Rita Musa, one of the longest serving medical directors of Lubaga Hospital. The transplant center is divided into three subunits. We have the operating theater, the intensive care unit, ICU, and then the CSSD, which is the central sterilizing and supplies department. We have a subdivision of the operating theater whereby we have a preparation room where the patient is received from the ward into this room. The preparation room serves as an initial point whereby the patient is assessed by the anesthesiologist just before the procedure. Any medication needed to be given before the procedure or any other intervention such as central lines are placed within this preparation room. From this room, we go on to the operating theaters, which are two. We have two operating rooms and a scrubbing area. The two operating rooms, when the transplant center kicks off and we're allowed to do transplants, one will serve as the donor room and then the other one will serve as the recipient room. The two rooms for this purpose have an adjoining door that connects the two rooms for ease of movement between the donor room and the recipient room. Currently, the unit is working on complex GI surgeries as well as hepatobiliary surgeries. Both open and also laparoscopic surgeries are taking place. After the operation has taken place, the patient is then moved to the post-anesthesia care unit where the patient is monitored postoperatively before they are transferred back to the ward. And if need be, we also have a high dependence unit where the patient can be placed for close monitoring by the anesthesia team. In the event that the patient needs an ICU admission, the ICU is within close proximity to the operating theater. The patient is then transferred from the OR straight into the intensive care unit for high-end postoperative care. In the event that the surgeons are taking a break, we have a staff lounge whereby still we have a screen that allows the surgeons or the staff within theater to continue following the cases that are happening, as this one of the operating rooms has a camera that can screen what is happening inside the operating room to the staff lounge. Thank you.